makeup. Pull out your compact mirror and politely ask him or her to turn themselves inside out for you. This is the poem that I've been afraid to expose my scars in. This is the poem for every poem that uses cliche wordplay and metaphors to conceal a disgust for makeup under the mask of empowerment. The queen, you don't need makeup to make up for something you are lacking. Poems that are as overdone as YouTube tutorials. I hear you, but your preference for my natural beauty has not been there on the days when I've been brave enough to face the world barefaced, and you forced your stares, comments, and recommendations into my already irritated skin. It has not been there on the days when no matter what I tried, acne and eczema were still hell-bent on leaving their mark. This is not vanity. It is survival. It's the only way I can avoid having smudges of your jokes rub off on the collar of my self-esteem. For those women who proudly proclaim, I don't need makeup, well, congratulations, fucking lacy. I'm sure there are a plethora of other things you need in order to be more than just pretty. Or for those men who profess, I don't like women who wear makeup, well, I don't like men who wear little dicks.
Come on.
So stop being one.
Yes.
This is not your cross to go bare. Forget walking a mile in my shoes. Your ass would last one step outside the front door in my skin. This is not shame. It is cringing each time I hear someone use the word makeup as if it is a curse, when the only curse has been my bad skin. And makeup has been a blessing. So your preconceived notions for why I'm a cover girl must have been placed in Photoshop, because the line you have crossed has become blurred. See, not all of us have the privilege of using hashtag no filter or hashtag I woke up like this. Others of us wake up dreading the breakout broom beneath our epidermis. This is for those of us who paint not to change our landscape, but merely to smooth out our canvas. This is not self-hate. This is loving the skin I'm in, even if it is only an illusion that can be washed away with soap and water. This is avoiding water parks and swimming pools. This is not me seeking a flood of compliments. This is not choice. It's a lack of one. It's being born a leopard, unwillingly put on the spot, unable to hide your own. See, nature. Nature has always had a way of randomly selecting which of its creatures will bear a defect. And there are some days when I wish that I were reptile enough to crawl my way out of the skin, but then there are those days when I tell myself that this is not hyperpigmentation. That at night when I'm asleep, God just holds my face so tight in admiration that he leaves his fingerprints on my cheek. This is not me wishing to be something I am not, but me passing as something I already know without a shadow of a blemish that I already am. And that, y'all, is fucking beautiful.
Thank you for loving hip hop, for giving poets a mic in the White House, for showing us how to raise our children, how to love strong women, how to make time for the important things, no matter how powerful you are. Thank you, Mr. President. Because of you,
look at my neck,
my children,
myself in the mirror, and know,
leader of